Beard patch. I have a... Anyway.
Okay, here we go here. All right. Hey guys, welcome to a fun vlog here on Matt's Rad Show. Thanks for dropping by. It's my first time. I'm a first ever geocacher. I've never done any geocaching before in my life.
If you don't know what geocaching is, it's basically a high-tech treasure hunt.
This young man right here, Mr.
Hey!
It's the geocaching vlogger!
Hey!
Joshua Johnson.
Woohoo!
He's here with us, folks.
I'm on the Matt's Rad Show.
That's right. You are now officially rad.
Finally rad.
On the show.
It's all over the world. There's over 3 million geocaches hidden all over the world. And you basically use a GPS-enabled device to find it. And people hide them. You can use your phone.
Sweet.
There's an app on your phone. You can download it for free.
Okay.
But yeah, they're hidden all over. They're all over this park. There's big one. There's big geocaches.
Sweet.
There's medium-sized, and there's little tiny itty-bitty ones too.
Itty-bitty geo. I shall call them mini caches.
Clash, clash. Okay. I tried so hard to watch that movie Rad from the 80s over and over again. And I didn't become rad. I was just attracted to Lori Loughlin the whole time.
She's an angel.
Yeah.
Oh, what's that?
Nature.
Look at this wonderful nature. Where are we here?
We're at the Gideon Pond Mission Park in Bloomington, Minnesota. So, I thought it'd be cool if we took Matt Geocache. See,
I'm stoked.
For people that don't, there's a term for people that don't know what geocaching is. It's called muggle.
Muggle.
So you are a muggle.
I'm a muggle.
We're going to turn you into a muggle no more.
What if I like being a muggle, though?
No.
Nature. Before I forget, I have a little present for you.
You do?
I do.
Dude, what is it?
Flatulence in a cup, folks. They have taken the art. The art of fart, and they've put it in cup form.
Yeah, finally!
You can stick your fingers in that bad boy and make all the fart noises you could ever want.
I want to open it right now.
Do it.
Wait for it.
And there's kind of an art to it, but let's see. So
you just kind of stick your thumb in it. It's not working yet.
Oh, you'll get it.
Oh! Ooh, that was a juicy one.
That was juicy. There's all sorts, millions and millions of farts are in that cup, just waiting to be released.
Forget geocaching, let's just do this all day.
All day. All day.
Wow.
So there you are, sir.
Wow.
Your very own fart cup.
I didn't even know I was going to get a present.
And they call it, I don't even know, noise putty. Flarp noise putty.
Well, a part of geocaching is that you trade for stuff. Like if we found something sweet, we can maybe put the fart cup in the cache for somebody else to find.
Nice.
Or else we can just keep it.
It's pretty cool.
Let's keep it.
So there you are, you're a fart cup.
Yeah.
You're no longer a fart cup muggle. What would it be?
It's great to be on the Matt's Rad Show. That's all I'm saying.
Awesome.
Let's do this. All right. Look at that. Those dots are geocaches. All right.
Is that plane really?
Really plane?
Shut up.
Really?
Did you see we're filming?
There are a couple of YouTubers down there. We're going to have to change our flight direction.
You download the app from your iPhone store or whatever, or your whatever store. And then you
a bunch of geocaches pop up.
And then you go and look for them, I guess. Now, does it tell you like the exact pinpoint location, or there's some searching that goes on?
Once you get within 20 feet, put it down, start looking around.
Okay, so it'll get you within 20 feet or so.
Yeah.
How many geocaches would you say you've done in your life?
Yep, so as of today, I have found 3,738 geocaches.
Are you serious?
Yep, I've been doing this I've been doing it for 8 years.
However many somebody out there do it, leave a comment. That number divided by 8 years, divided by 365 days, how many geocaches he's finding a day?
Well,
this is mushy ground. I like it.
I go for, when I film my geocaches, I tend to go for quality over quantity.
Gotcha.
I want to take people to really cool things.
A white belt.
Yeah.
That's like, would you say that's black belt or like brown belt?
I'd say it's more purple.
Purple belt?
Yeah.
That's pretty up there though. I was a white belt with two yellow stripes as kids.
Oh really?
I almost made it to the yellow belt, but I dropped out because I wanted to ride my bike.
Like Ralph Macchio?
Like Ralph Macchio, that's right.
Ralph Macchio, like
How many, I wonder how many kids signed up for karate right after they've watched Karate Kid. And then I saw Rad, and it was bikes. Then I saw Back to the Future, and it was skateboard. And I swear, like, every time Michael J. Fox, like, I did that. I grabbed onto the back of the ice cream truck as a kid on my skateboard.
Oh, that's
and
awesome.
Me and my friend went hauling butt down the street. We got freaked out and had to let go. So it's gone. I'd be like Michael J. Fox.
Nature!
Nature! Mother?
Time to shoot pictures. It's like high noon.
Yeah.
Life's the worst.
Yeah. Gotta get that magic hour, man.
Yeah. And, but stuff like this is really. So, they could be all different kinds of sizes. All
okay.
Right?
Gotcha.
Let's go easy. We're gonna go to a geocache called Colossus.
Okay.
It's huge!
It sounds big.
It's a huge geocache.
It's colossal.
If you can't find this one, you should just quit right away.
Okay.
All right, let's go. Let's go to Colossus.
Let's do this. Colossus!
Colossus!
I did a whole episode on trees.
I did
a whole episode on trees at the Minnesota Arboretum in the fall with my mom. I was like, there's gonna be like two people that watch this episode.
All right.
It still hasn't hit 200. That was like last fall. People are like, trees, Matt? Seriously? Ooh, look at this. Going right into the... Ooh. Nice.
Dual education.
Edumacation.
So here's mine. See, right there, here we are. So we're in here.
Okay.
And the geocache is here.
Okay.
So you can see on the map, the cool thing is that you're like, oh, this is weird. You can just go to compass and you just follow the arrow.
Oh, cool.
So we're 0.31 miles.
Nice.
From Colossus.
From Colossus.
Colossus.
Sweet nature. Is this where Colossus walked by?
Yeah.
And left a path?
Yeah. Right through here.
Dude.
Colossus was here. And they're trying to keep him out.
Put up a fence.
This fence.
Have you seen that movie? I don't know what it's called. Have you seen it?
Yep.
I think it's called Troll, actually.
Troll?
I think it's called Troll.
Was there a movie called Troll in the 80s where those things came out of the toilets?
Oh, I think that was Ghoulies.
Ghoulies. That's pretty much the same thing, right?
Maybe it was Troll. I don't know.
No.
That's awesome. I remember watching that movie.
So it was weird.
There was Ghoulies and Critters. Remember Critters?
Yeah.
Oh gosh, Critters. Creepy. That was a weird one.
I think what happened was like Gremlins took off.
Yeah.
We were like, we gotta make more
creepy
animal creature movies.
Oh, that's totally it.
All right, Matt.
Okay.
100 feet. I feel like Arnold Schwarzenegger a bit in Commando.
Once you get within 20 feet, start just looking around. Use your geosenses.
Oh, geosense. Okay, yeah, we're within 11 feet.
Okay.
Should I keep going? It's still
just pointing. Just put it down, just start looking around. You're looking for a big container.
Hello, Mr. Container.
Okay, look around.
Where is it?
Can the containers be, is it like going to be a box?
It could be anything.
I think I see it. There's something in those trees right there.
Matt!
I see you.
Congratulations.
Is that it? I found my first geocache?
You found it.
Yes.
Woo.
Okay.
You guys, look at this thing.
That is a monster.
That is a huge geocache.
That is a big one. I don't know. If I miss that.
I know.
Then shame on me.
Well, I wanted, Matt, I wanted success.
Success? Well, thank you. Appreciate
and
that.
And you succeeded.
I feel built up.
All right, let's get it.
I feel ready.
You can move it. I think you should.
Oh, look at all.
Oh, it's attached.
We got swag.
Okay.
We got swag in a Ziploc bag.
Swag in a Ziploc bag. All right, there's not a lot, so we're gonna add some swag to this. So.
Add some swag.
So, I don't know if you know this, but you, with the swag, if you like something in it, you can take it, but you must trade for something of equal or greater value.
That seems fair.
All right, so
that seems fair to me.
I've got some things.
Got some stuff to put in here?
I got some stuff to put in the cache. Some really good stuff. This is collectible.
It's a little tight guy.
Aww. Yeah, I want to take you home. You're naughty. You're a naughty car.
Tommy Boy, anybody?
Tommy Boy, I got it right away.
Fraggle Rock Season 1 on DVD.
Are you serious?
Oh. Are you going to put that in here?
I'm putting this in here. Because normally you don't find a cache this big to fit something like this. And I thought, okay, you know what? I've watched this so many times. Give other people joy and enjoyment. Right?
Dance your cares away. Worry for another day.
Music play.
Down a frag of rock. So I signed it. There's a little spot to sign. I signed the geocache. And we put some more cash in there.
Or some cat. Well, what do you call it? The swag.
Swag.
Stuff we all get.
Swag. So a bunch of swag in there. Joshua put some sweet swag in this one. So you guys should start geocaching with this one. Come rock that Fraggle Rock DVD, dude. That's amazing.
Geocaching.
Every time I'm in the forest doing stuff like this, I always hear Predator music in my head.
So it's not always so much about what you find in the cache. It's more about the thrill of the hunt.
But yeah, totally.
Sometimes you do find pretty cool stuff. Sometimes when geocaches are published, like you get an email notification and it's like a race.
Okay.
You can get there first. And then
there's
a first to find prize.
Ooh.
And I found
Cannonball Run.
Yeah, totally. So I found Caribou gift cards.
Nice.
I found a Twins shirt once.
Nice.
That was cool.
That's pretty cool.
So yeah, lots of geo coins. That's another level.
Oh, cool.
Talk about that later.
Man, all this stuff has just been going on right underneath my nose.
I know.
Geocaching army out there doing cool stuff.
I know. Muggle no more, right here. Muggle no more.
Muggle no more.
Sharks are pretty rare to find in the wild.
Yeah.
Because people steal them as a convention. So. Lost. 206 feet away.
Right, we are 134 feet away from our next cache.
Now this one's not gonna be as big.
Okay. It's gonna take me longer to find it probably. 51, 46. 42. Getting closer. Getting closer. So we're within 20 feet.
We are.
Okay.
I have already found this one before, so it's all you, dude.
So it's within 20 feet of here.
Looking around.
Now, is it gonna be, I guess it could be any color, huh?
Could be any color.
Can it be a log like this?
Could be. Matt's within 20 feet.
Within 20 feet. Checking the perimeter.
Checking the perimeter.
Oh, wait, I see something over here.
Oh.
I see it.
Yeah. Your second ever geocache.
Number two. This is like half the size.
I know.
So the next one could be half this size.
Yes.
And so on. Cool.
Yeah.
I'm sweating. Geocache number two.
Oh, we got some Halloween pencils in here. Very nice, very nice.
Got a little vlog book. Halloween surplus.
Yes.
This is fun. That's one of my favorite holidays, isn't it? These things. This. We could make dinosaurs out of this. Edo crystallized inside it. Just you guys can't see it, but I can. Cool.
All right.
Let's get her signed.
Sign to get out of your
studio. Look, there's stamps. See, there's me.
Oh, nice.
See, people stamp there.
They don't stamp.
They don't have to. I thought this was like a good vlogger.
That's awesome.
Thanks.
Matt's
Rad
Show. Bam. Where's our next one? Where's our next one?
Here's what we're gonna do. Here's the strategy.
Okay. Here's the strategy.
We're gonna get out of the woods because I wanna give you a variety of experience.
Okay.
So we're gonna find some urban geocaches.
Urban it up.
Typically they're smaller and they're very difficult to find sometimes.
Ooh, okay.
All right.
So you're up in the hard level.
You're ready. You're at a red belt now.
If I was a video game, I would click it like advanced.
Yeah.
Are we out of the woods? Are we out of the woods? Are we out of the woods? Is there any other lyrics to that song? Have you even heard that song? I'm a little parched.
Water? Are we finding water around here?
Water. A cookie. Mountain Dew. Cheeseburger. Maybe some pretzels. And some beef jerky. Salt Lick. You got any Salt Licks on your Jared Shaw? Beef jerky or like, so like a salt stick? Or one of them salt cubes? Just pepper shaker?
This is a good learning moment. So anytime you go caching, don't forget your water.
Or your
salt water.
Salt water.
Salt. You're reaching for one of those brownies.
Brownie.
With nuts in it. Yeah, one of those.
Alrighty, so we're in the car now.
We're in the car! We're
headed to our next cache location.
We're gonna get more intense.
More intense
like
now.
Smaller, tinier.
Little caches. Little tents. Yeah. We're gonna get in tents that are about this big.
Yeah. Or in cabins.
Cabins.
Yeah. The struggle with urban geocaching is there's people around.
Oh, right.
So there's other muggles.
Other muggles.
And you don't want to look suspicious.
They're probably wondering what you're doing.
Right.
Snooping around.
All right, so geocache is somewhere around here. I've looked around here, got a little bit of a hint.
Okay.
It said, how are you going to cross the crosswalk here? So
right.
There's a crosswalk.
Yep.
So I'm supposed to go, it's got to be under here.
Okay.
Somewhere, so I'm looking.
Anything?
Oh, you found a bolt.
Screw just fell out.
But wait a minute.
That's not...
It wasn't screwed in anything.
Did I just break this thing? Yeah,
I don't think so. Wait a minute. That might be the cache.
Whoa! This is cool.
There it is, folks. All of its glory. Moving on.
Feels good.
Okay, so we found that one.
Yep.
A little itty bitty screw.
Yep.
Or a bolt, I would guess it was called. Bolt.
Bolt cache.
Bolt cache. And got that one done. Now we're off to our next one.
Oh! So you're gonna be pumped.
I'm excited.
You're gonna be excited.
I'm excited about this one.
Approaching the next geocache, and I think you're gonna like it.
Dude, is that a TARDIS? Shut up, dude. That is so cool.
That is
what?
A little free library.
Free public. That's amazing, dude.
The cool thing is, there's a geocache in that little free library.
Seriously?
And we're gonna find it, and it's a good one.
Oh. This is so cool. Check it out. Police call box. Awesome.
This is called like a gadget cache.
Gadget cache, okay.
Easy to find.
Okay, yeah.
But here. Tricky to get into. All right, tricky. So let's do some exploring.
Easy to find, tricky to get into. So I'm guessing this isn't gonna work.
No.
This is so cool. Legit TARDIS. Little take leaf library.
Okay, so this is a little free library. Do you know anything about them?
No.
People put little libraries, you know, you could trade books, you know, in it.
Uh-huh.
So it's multi-use.
Multi-use.
It's
little, it's free.
Yeah, and this one just happens to be a TARDIS. So how cool is that?
It's way cool.
So now it's time to find the geocache.
So
good luck.
It's in here somewhere? Is there other parts to it or on the back, or is this the
whole? Yeah, I think you should search around in there, yeah. No, there's more. Oh! What is it? It's a fake books.
It's fake books.
Cool.
You're like, what is this? A free library.
Okay, set that aside.
The books are fake. Okay.
All right.
Can you see
what's
it
this? It? Look, it says official geocache.
These do not serve as an official game piece. Refer to geocaching.com for details. So, we gotta figure out how to. There's a battery, a place for a battery, so.
Okay.
Chinese looking glass. I got a bunch of batteries back here.
Nice. That's attached. So. Ooh, what's that? What is that?
Dude, this is like some next level stuff right here, man.
What is that?
It's a thing from Doctor Who.
Yeah, I don't know what it's called. I can't remember.
He basically can do anything he wants to with this thing.
Okay.
And I forget what it's called, too, though.
Some batteries. He's gonna put the battery in.
Put the battery in.
Alright. Alright.
Battery.
Alright, we got a light. Okay.
I don't know. Can you hear that?
Whoa, what was it?
Can you hear that? It's going.
Nice.
Ooh, I hear it.
Nice, dude.
I think that's a tool.
Open geocache.
What? All right, Matt. You got it open.
Yeah, when you hit this here, right there, it opened up. It unlocked it.
Yeah.
Then you can get into it.
So cool.
So it's got the little...
There's the logbook.
The logbook and all kinds of stuff, dude. This is some next level geocaching stuff. For I sure. feel like honored that you would take me to this level of a geocache on my first run around.
Well, dude, here's the deal.
This is amazing, dude.
I've seen your videos. Your viewers will love Doctor Who.
Doctor Who, man.
Geocache.
We're in the Doctor Who realm.
Awesome.
I wish I could fit inside this TARDIS and go for a little ride around the universe.
For sure.
Got all those Doctor Who, but I wish I had some cool Doctor Who stuff to put in here.
I know, right?
I might have to come back and put some cool stuff in here.
Yeah.
Cool. All right, should we get her signed?
Sign that sucker.
It's gotta be a pen. What kind of library doesn't have a pen? Oh, here we go. Bam.
Perfect.
I got one. That's rad. Show. Bam.
Nice.
Yeah.
Yeah. Sweet.
So, close her up.
You did it!
Da-dum.
That was a cool geocache.
It's very cool. I thought when you were like, it's gonna take some time to get into it, I was like, that was easy. Like, I thought you were talking about. But that's cool. Total legit, cool, awesome thing in here to get your geocache stuff out.
Yeah. Goodbye, TARDIS. I should use some TARDIS sound effects.
Alrighty.
Alright!
Well, that's all the geocache we're gonna do for today. Thank you, Joshua, for taking me on my first ever geocaching adventure.
Awesome.
I enjoyed it, sir. I had fun. I had fun.
Cool.
I saw nature.
Nature.
I saw three geocaches.
Four.
Did I see four?
One, two.
Oh yeah, there were four. Two in the woods, the bolt, and of course the TARDIS.
Four.
That TARDIS was amazing, folks. Yeah. So if you have never geocached before, go check out his channel. What's your channel again?
The Geocaching Vlogger.
Geocaching Vlogger. I'll link it below. Awesome. And make sure you guys go check out his channel. Go learn more about geocaching. Have some fun, then get out there and do it yourself. It's
for
good
sure.
time. Get out there and do some adventures, guys. So,
why not?
From all of us here at Matt's Rad Show, myself, Joshua today, Geocaching Vlogger. Thanks for watching this episode, guys. And we'll catch you later.
Fart Cup.
Fart Cup.
Ooh, that was a juicy one.
That was juicy. There's all sorts, I mean, millions and millions of farts are in that cup. Just waiting to be released.
Forget geocaching, let's just do this all day.
All day. All day.